The time has come. June 2nd, 2007, from God the Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for all those who have ears to hear.
Beloved, hear me, and so do as I command you. The time has come, the time is here, when all iniquity must depart from Jacob. My children, hear the voice of the Lord your God, your Redeemer. I am he, and you shall behold my glory. And in him, who I had sent and am sending, shall you know me. The Father and the Son are one. And if we are one, then you shall be one in us, in truth. Yea, the time draws hence, when we shall be one in you, and you in us. For I will be your God, and you will be my people, the chosen flock, the flock beloved of the shepherd. Thus says the Lord Jesus, even all who shall come to me shall be mine, and I shall be theirs. For I live in them, and among them, and they in me. Amen. And so it will be at the end of this world. I shall come. Lo, I shall destroy and sanctify, and many beyond the numbering of a man shall follow me. Even all these who have come to know my voice and believe with their whole hearts. Though they had not seen me, yet they know me because I come to live in them. Behold the glorious wedding party arrayed in robes of white, clean and shining. Beloved, what of these who have not heard? And what of these who have heard and yet have not seen, and seen though they have not heard? What of these who call of themselves by my own name? Who do not obey my voice, though I do speak to them and call to them? They are a rebellious house, a very stiff-necked, high-minded, disobedient house, who do call of themselves by my own name. Servants, hear and know, and be pricked in your hearts. The day of the Lord is here. It has come. Lo, it is here. It has come. Who will go for me? Who shall I send? Who will go out in the name of the Lord God of Israel? And bear upon his chest and in his forehead the name of the Holy One of Israel, your Redeemer, Yeshua, the King of Glory. Who shall suffer for me? Who will crucify themselves for me? Even all those who I see of myself residing in them shall go out amongst the multitude. And even these shall I give a new and renewed voice, yea, a strong voice. Behold, they shall sing and have tribulation 10 days. Lo, they shall be cast into prison and held in captivity by Satan. Yet they shall by no means be bound, neither can their mouths be stopped. Yea, I, even I, shall free them, and they shall fly away on the third day. Yet a remnant of these I shall leave behind, to gather in the wild flock, the lost, shattered flock, the dispersed of many nations. They, the wild flock, shall fall and wail, and I shall comfort them and guide them, for these I must also bring. And these, even these, though they were broken, though they shall suffer many bruises, though they shall become the flock of the slaughter, by no means shall they pass from my sight. And when the time comes, and it shall surely come, I shall slay those who slew them, and slaughter them who slaughtered you, O most beloved of my heart. You have suffered here among these wolves, who have torn you and bitten you, yet you sang, how beautiful did you sing. And lo, your voice reached into the hearts of the multitude. And by the power of my own spirit did you testify to the greatest of all loves. And in that same moment you were slain and lifted up to heaven. Yet your words did not return void, for all the hearers were also slain in their hearts. Even as the sand of the seashore shall they run to me. And of these, even a great remnant, who did flee at the face of the abomination who makes desolate. Even all of these shall mount up on the wings of eagles and be hidden for a time, times and the dividing of time, from the face of the devourer of flesh. He shall be devoured. And those who follow him are consumed, meat for the birds, dwelling place of the worm. No more breath shall they attain, nor shall their souls escape my glory, nor the power of my sword which proceeds from my mouth. I shall roar, yea, I shall roar as the raging lion, and they shall be cut to pieces, they shall be consumed. Both flesh and bone, and sinew and soul, shall be consumed from my presence by the word of my mouth. For strong is the Lord, hot is his anger. He shall not spare, neither any mercy shall be shown to the beast, nor his prophet, nor to any of those who do follow them. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. I shall repay. Thus says the Lord God of Israel, the God of all creation. Son of man, tread the grapes in the winepress of the wrath of my fury. Tread them, O son of man, O Emmanuel. Tread them until nothing remains. Destroy them, and even all things that have led my people into sin. Even all things that have caused them to wander from me. Son of man, your enemies are your footstool, says the Lord of hosts. Silence them, cast them down. Consume them in my fury, consume and destroy. Let them be no more before my face. Repay, says the Lord, repay. Even double for that which they have done to even all those I had sent to them. Double for all those who are called by my name. Even double, and double again for even all they have done to the little ones. For all these innocent they have destroyed. And for all those innocent they have filled with hate and violence and sin. Destroy them all, says the Lord God of all created, known and unknown. Serve to them double, says the Lord, and destroy, says the Lord God. Yet do not make a total end. For the sake of my servant Noah, for the sake of Jacob, my Israel, for the sake of Judah, my servant, and for the sake of these beloved, called by the name of their shepherd, make not a total end. Wipe the slate clean, and rebuild and restore the sanctuary and the garden. Reconcile even all things to yourself, and rule over all nations, tongues, and kindred. Even over all things, heaven and earth. Rest 1,000 years.